Whoa, you narcissistic, disgusting fool. How can you be so superficial to want people to like you and give you attention and blow up your phone? Actually disgusting, gross, fake, lame. You don't need to operate life based on other people's validation. You don't need to be so desperate for attention. Hey, but why not have it, am I right? Being popular kind of enhances your life in many ways. It commands respect for you and your family, makes life easier, and gives us more options to find genuine people. Unless you became popular through some very superficial means, like trying to be someone you're not. I think it's only bad to demand validation from other people when it stops you from becoming who you want to be, and it makes you betray who you are, lie to yourself. But otherwise, for the most part, why is it bad though? Sure, don't let others dictate your feelings, but I think that's entirely a you problem. We are social animals. Primitively, we belong in tribes, and how other people see us strongly determines where we stand in the social hierarchy and how much welfare we receive. So why the hell wouldn't we care? Besides, that's close to how it works nowadays anyways. Social media is so prevalent now, having social proof has become very universally important and seen as an object of status and respect and competence. Social validation is pretty much necessary in our lives nowadays. Everything would not exist without social constructs, without culture, without practices. And there's nothing wrong with that. It is biological that we want to care about what others think of us and where we stand in importance. I think you are supposed to care what other people think, but it does not have to negatively impact you emotionally or force you to betray yourself. I think that's a you problem. You should care, but you should be very wary about how high you place how people care about you in your priority list. It should not be that important in terms of making decisions. But hey, here's how you get people to text you first. Cool intro, let's do another cool intro, because why the hell not? Who's gonna stop me, huh? My first suggestion, text them first. Yep, you little shit. You're not gonna enjoy that dominance and power you feel over people by them just being drawn to you. You have to text them first. That's the first step. I don't think any popular dude just woke up with everybody being obsessed over them. It's more like a sequence and accumulation of being sociable, having things going for you. For example, maybe they look really good, so they have high standings in the social hierarchy since people gravitate towards them. Or maybe they're very good at something. Maybe they participate in a lot of events. They're very prevalent in whatever environment you're in. Everybody that interests you, text them first. You increase your social proof, your circle, by texting them first. Especially when you're a person of value, your attention becomes more valuable. And after learning what kind of person you're like, which I'm hoping is likable, they will be very reciprocative. If you're interested in someone, text them first. If they don't reciprocate after 3 to 5 times, then remove. You're free to drop them. That means they likely don't have as much interest in you as you have in them. Or they do have interest, but they enjoy that power you give them, that pseudo-dominance they feel when you always come to them. Many people are afraid of that, but you should be wary of that, and regardless, you should text first. And if they enjoy that power, then likely you don't want them to be your friend either. So you just leave. If they want you back, you will be able to tell. After you text 3 to 5 times and they don't reciprocate, it's pretty clear that the interest is kind of one-sided. But we have to understand that people are afraid to text first. Giving others power is terrifying. But just stay aware of that. Understand it's a common fear and do it anyways. Understand that you're not giving them any power because you will leave no matter what after 3 to 5 times of texting first. Keep giving to those that you're interested in, and not all of them will stick, but many will. Whatever stage of value you are at right now, maybe like a 10% chance they will stick. Let me go full edgy mode on you, alright? These that stick will stay, and they will increase your social proof the more that stay. And which will then increase your social hierarchy value. See that? Which will then increase your chances of reciprocation and increase the amount of people that text you first. Because you seem like someone of value since you have such a large social proof. But little did they know, you actually started that yourself by texting 5 billion people. By giving to 5 billion people. Become something of substance. Get good at something. Give people reason to text. It sounds superficial, but people are too afraid to seem desperate. So by getting good at something, by broadcasting it, by living their life and sharing with others, you give them an excuse to say hi, you give them an excuse to make a witty comment, you give people opportunity to message you. But please become something of substance first. Make some like substantial amount of progress so you can actually take pride in that thing. You don't have to broadcast everything you do, but make it a habit. Broadcast parts of your life that people can ask a question. Show off an endeavor. Focus on making progress in every avenue. Do things you love and broadcast them. Increase your opportunities. Go do things that give you discomfort. Like public speaking, like a shitty part-time job, like participating in events, like performing. People love to talk about things that bring discomfort and that takes a lot of willingness and determination to go and do. Because we are sadists. Unfortunately, or fortunately, opportunity not only increases your social skills, but gives you things to talk about and gives you things to hold on to, which will widen your scope of ideals and make you a more interesting person. A popular person doesn't start off with people just obsessed with them. They just text 1,000 people now and then, and because of that, 100 people text them back now and then. Your value and competence will be reflected in the number of people who text you back now and then, who choose to reciprocate. That's just how it works. It's not like those dramas where people are just obsessed with the popular person. Other people are humans too, all act on self-interest and individual perspective. All people have strange tendencies and people that they naturally gravitate to for some reason. There's plenty of things you do that you cannot really explain right now. You can't reason with people's tendencies and try to manipulate them into liking you or doing what you want by being someone you're not. Not only is that kind of evil, but that will also probably not entirely work because people are inconsistent. They don't truly know what they want half the time. And if you bank your life on acting certain ways to attract people, you're going to end up very frustrated because you tried to reason with the unpredictable human tendencies. You assume that there's only one pathway to attracting people, and that is by being someone you're not, and that makes you more attractive to people. And you assume that one thing directly leads to another, so you can control people that way, if that makes any sense. Sorry to break it to you, but you are wrong. People are people, unfortunately. I wish there are pawns too that I can play around and abuse, but you know, it's an unfair world. Unfortunate, I can't play around with people the way I want and use them as pawns in my game. Unfortunate, humans are humans, people are people, so we move. I hope you become the person you wish to be. To a better world.